Welcome to today's tutorial. First, we will do a little bit of group work in which we learn a bit about recursion and library organization in practice. So, to get started with it, first of all, you should be now assigned in Blackboard in pairs, and you should do pair programming by sharing your screen with your colleague. So, identify with your colleague who of you will share the screen. Maybe you can both as well type on similar codes if you like. So the task we try to perform is that we will implement the greatest common divisor, the GCD algorithm. What does GCD do? Well, if you give it two numbers, it finds out which is the biggest divisor that you can use to divide both numbers. Here we have the example 112 and 24. The biggest divisor is 8. Well, which is the biggest number that divides both numbers. Here you can find the definition of the algorithm in a pseudocode. So GCD A and B, well, you see a little branching here and another branch here. And well, you don't have to understand why the code works. It's just important to basically take this little pseudocode and encode it in C. But while doing so, we will make a couple of modifications. So first of all, our goal is to make a little command line program, which I can feed the two input numbers, and then I get as output the expected output number. Here's the input example, here's the output example. So we do this by creating a small library. And here we give you the header file for the library. Let me just open it and save it. So this here is supposed to be our header file. Here at the beginning we find some guards, which are part of the preprocessor directives, which we learn later in the lecture. And here it's basically here an if, and here it's an end if, which belongs together. So then we find here our declaration of the function. We could use Doxygen as an example with more documentation. Let's take this and copy and paste it into Atom. And we should call it mygcd_lib.h. mygcd_lib.h. So here we go. I just saved the file. Let me have a look with ls. Yes, here is my header file. That's right. Now I go back and I should create the implementation of this function. Here is, you know, we get started with a pretty much empty implementation just to make it work. By making it work, I mean to be able to compile our code. Let me save it as mygcdlib.c, save the content, right? So here's the implementation of the function GCD, where we should later integrate our implementation of the pseudocode that was given, but at the moment we always return zero, okay? So next, we should compile the code. Create a main function inside the file gcd.c. So we have to do this still. Let me real quick do that. So I open yet another file, gcd.c. I should implement my main function. And from here, I should call the function in our header file, which is called GCD. So let me just copy and paste it. So I basically should sort of call this function. Let me save a result calling this function. And I just input two numbers. Why not taking the ones that we know about at the moment? And let me include standard IO library to be able to print the result, right? So that's probably always a good first step. Now, the problem will be when I try to compile it, that the compiler will say, I don't know anything about this GCD function. So let me try now to compile it. And here you find how to compile it as a string, which I will now explain to you. So we call GCC, our GNU C compiler. We say G3, which is debugging option, warnings all. And now we give him an include directory, the dot, which is the current working directory. Then we want to create a binary called GCD with the O flag from GCD.c. And we want to input compile as well mygcdlibrary.c. So let's try what's going to happen. Well, the compiler raised the warning, and the warning says, I don't implicit declaration of the function GCD. So it basically says, I don't know anything about GCD, but it kind of compiled. Okay, we should generally treat all warnings as errors. So that is a problem. And how do we fix it? Well, we learned from the lecture, we have to include the header file of our library. It's called mygcdlib.h, right? We just created this file. So here in this header file, we now find our declaration, which is the prototype of this function GCD. So let's see again what happens if I try to compile it. No warning. That's pretty good. And I can run it and it returns zero. Well, why does it return zero? Well, because we basically said here that the result is zero. Okay, let me, for the sake of simplicity now, return x plus y as a result, just that we see that something else is returned. Okay, so I compile it and I execute it, and the result is 136, which means that it kind of has worked. So now we have a working workflow, which is always the first step to implement your code, right? And what we should do now is we should implement the GCD function inside your library. So inside our mygcdlib.c, we should, of course, now take this pseudo code and implement it properly. And I will stop now here because I think this is the most important part. Once you've done that, you should then find out and use the code to pass the two user arguments. Because our goal, as we said, was something like we wanted to say GCD 112.24 and then get basically the correct output, which was 8. Okay? So good luck, and if you have questions, please ask us on Teams.